Okay, so here we have an equilateral triangle where all the sides measure 4 centimeters. Now we also know for an equilateral triangle, all the angles measure 60 degrees. And they're asking us to find the area. All right, so for the area, I know the formula is equal to 1/2 base times height, right? The formula for the area of a triangle. 1/2 base times height. So here, I already know the base. So this is equal to 1/2. Now the base is 4 centimeters, but I don't know what the height is, right? So I need to figure out the height of this triangle. So to do that, what I'm going to do is look at the peak here and drop an altitude. And so when I construct an altitude, this will be a right angle. I'm not drawn to scale, it's a little bit off. But I'm going to look at this right triangle here on this side where the base of that right triangle is actually 2 centimeters. Okay, so there's a number of ways to find the height here. We can use trigonometry, or in this case, I think we can just use regular Pythagorean theorem. Okay, so I know for this green triangle, I can say leg squared plus leg squared equals the hypotenuse squared. So in this case, 8 squared plus 2 squared equals 4 squared, right? 8 squared, 2, and a 4. 4 is the hypotenuse. All right, and that gives me 8 squared plus 4 equals 16. Subtracting 4, 8 squared equals 12. Okay, and then extracting the square root, taking the square root of both sides, don't forget the plus or minus, we get h equals, well, since it's geometry, I'm going to use plus the square root of 12. Now, 12 is 4 times 3. And so the exact value here would be, for the height, 2 square root of 3 centimeters. Okay, so with that, I can go back to the original problem where I was actually calculating the area, and I can replace the height there with 2 square root of 3 centimeters. All right, 1/2 base times height, and then we can do the work. All right, so 1/2 times 4 is 2 times the 2 square root of 3, and then centimeters times centimeters is centimeters squared, or 4 square root of 3 centimeters squared. So that's the exact answer. And we can actually do that on a calculator if it wanted the approximate answer. On a calculator, I'm just going to type in 4 square root of 3 and hit the approximate button. I get about 6.9 centimeters squared. And that's going to be my approximate answer. And there you have it, the area of an equilateral triangle. For the next example here in section 1.5, I want to do number 29. And so here it says, an observer stands at the edge of a sinkhole and looks to the bottom. If the angle of depression to the bottom of the hole is 82 degrees and the hole is 5 meters wide, how deep is the hole? Okay, so we have to go and understand what the angle of depression is. So let's go back up and see here that in the textbook, the angle of elevation is the angle that an object makes with the horizontal. Okay, so from the horizontal looking up, that's an angle of elevation. And if I was up here at the balloon and looking out at the horizontal, the angle looking down from the horizontal is the angle of depression. Okay, so let's try to draw a picture and then figure out the height of the sinkhole. Okay, now often with these problems, it's helpful to draw a picture. All right, so we have a sinkhole, and I don't know, it looks something like this. And we have a person, an observer, up here looking down. All right, so the problem said the line of sight to the bottom of the hole was had an angle of depression of 82 degrees. And so if the observer is looking down here to the bottom, the angle of depression is the angle with the horizontal. So that's 82 degrees right there. Now it also said that the hole measures 5 meters in length there. All right, so this is sort of the picture. This is the given information. Let's assume this is a right angle right here. And we can apply our knowledge of trigonometry on this particular right triangle, where this is, say, the height. Okay? All right, so once we got an okay picture here, I know we have two parallel lines here, so this is one of those alternate interior angles, so I know this is going to be 82 degrees. And so looking at this illustration, I need to find H. And the side, H is the side opposite, right? And I'm given the side adjacent. So I need to think, you know, which trig function associates opposite with adjacent? Well, after some thought, that's tangent, right? So tangent of any particular angle is defined to be opposite over adjacent. And so in this particular case, I could say tangent of 82 degrees is equal to H over 5. Okay, and then cross multiplying 5 times tangent of 82 degrees equals the H. And then I can just do that on a calculator. So 5, let me clear that out. 5 tangent of 82 degrees. Make sure you're in degree mode. And then enter. And so I'm just going to round that off to one decimal place and say that's approximately, what is that, 35.6. And we need units here. And so the units were given in meters. So that would be the height of the sinkhole is approximately 35.6 meters. For the next problem I want to do here is number 55 in our textbook, section 1.5. It says a ship traveled 15 kilometers on a bearing of north 50 degrees west, and then dropped anchor. How far north and how far west did the ship travel? Okay, so I notice here it gives a bearing. So we need to first understand what bearing is. Okay, so here's a good picture in the textbook. Now, bearing is a measure of direction. So bearings always start from the north-south line. They have an angle, and then they end on the west-east line. Okay, so here we have a compass. North is up, south is down, left is west, and right is east. So right here, you're looking at north 60 degrees west. So you start 60 degrees west. So you start on north, because that comes first, and then you mark out 60 degrees in the westerly direction, and that's the direction north 60 degrees west. Now here's north 45 degrees east, starting at north, marking out 45 degrees east. That's that direction. If S comes first, you got to start on the south line, mark out the 20 degrees in the westerly direction, and that's south 20 degrees west. And then finally, south 75 degrees east, since S comes first, you start on the south line, you mark 75 degrees in the easterly direction. All right, so those are directions. Now let's go back to our problem. Okay, so now that we know what bearing is, let's go ahead and try to draw a nice picture for this and then solve the problem. Okay, now it gave us a bearing of north 50 degrees west, and it said the boat traveled for 15 kilometers. All right, so when working with bearing problems, try to make a nice big picture. Give yourself lots of space. When you write a compass in front of yourself, north is usually up, south is down, west is to the left, east is to the right, and it kind of spells we, that's how I remember it. Now the bearing here says north 50 degrees west, so we want to start from the north and then mark out 50 degrees in the westerly direction. So there's the bearing, north 50 degrees west in green. Now the boat is here and it dropped anchor. All right, so there's my boat. The question wanted me to find how far north and how far south did it go. So this is the distance north, and how far west, right? And this is the distance west. So I'll call this distance N, that distance W, and that of course makes a right triangle. And so from here we can use right triangle trig. Oh, I also know the distance on that bearing is 15 kilometers. All right, so there's the picture. That's the given information. We need to find N and W. All right, so let's go for W, the distance west first. So I look at that, and I see that it's the side opposite of the given 50 degrees. And then the hypotenuse is 15. So opposite over hypotenuse, right? What comes to mind? Well, sine, right? Sine of theta is defined to be opposite over hypotenuse. So for this particular picture, I can write sine of 50 degrees equals W over, right, the west direction over 15, right? W over 15. Okay, cross multiplying, I get 15. Sine of 50 degrees equals the W. And so on a calculator, all I have to do is type in 15 sine of 50. So make sure you're in degree mode. And I get 15 sine of 50. And that's about 11.5. And the units here are in kilometers. So I would put kilometers, right? That's the distance west. Okay, now let's look for n. Right, to figure out n, I can use trig. N is the side adjacent, and I have the hypotenuse. And so for that, I know cosine of theta is defined to be adjacent over hypotenuse. So in this particular case, cosine of 50 degrees equals, right, the side adjacent is n, so n over 15. And then cross multiplying, 15 cosine of 50 is equal to the n. Or in other words, n is approximately our answer here. 15 cosine of 50, approximately 9.6 kilometers. All right, so that's how far north the boat went. And then here's how far the boat went in the westerly direction. So we found those values. Now, the next one I want to do is number 61 in the textbook. I'm in section 1.5 again. This one says, a ship leaves the marina and sails on a bearing of north 42 degrees east for 12 miles. Then it turns and sails 10 more miles in the direction of south 48 degrees east. How far did the ship sail, and what is the bearing from the marina? Okay, this one has two directions, right? We have north 42 degrees east for 12 miles, and then turning, we get on a bearing here, south 48 degrees east. Let's try to draw a picture. Okay, now in the problem, it gave us two bearings, right? And so north 42 degrees east was the first leg of the trip for 12 miles. When making these illustrations, you want to make them big. Okay, don't squish yourself in. Nice and big illustrations. Problem becomes like a little bit easier. When you draw on a compass in front of yourself, typically we write north as up and south is down. Okay, west is left and east is right. I like to remember that as we. All right, so there's my compass. And the first direction here is north 42 degrees east. So from the north line, I need to mark out 42 degrees in the easterly direction. And so this is the easterly direction, so here's the 42 degrees that's given, and I went, or the boat or whatever went 12 miles, right? And so he's there now, he's right here, right? That's the first leg of the trip, and then he turned on bearing south 48 degrees east. Okay, so what I'm going to want to do is put in another compass where he's at that point, north, south, west, and east. And mark out from there south 48 degrees east. Right, so I start at the south line, marking out 48 degrees. It's about like that. He went 10 miles. Right here's 48 degrees, and this is 10 miles. All right. Sorry, I got a little squished. 48 degrees right there. And so now the boat is right here. Okay. So the question is, how far and on what bearing from the marina is the boat? And so what I'm actually looking for is this distance from the marina, right? Remember, the marina is where we started. Okay, so that should be pretty straightforward to find this distance right here. Let's call it x, and that's how far he is away from the marina. Awesome. So there's a nice picture with my two bearings. All right, now from there, we need to solve this. So I need this angle right here. And so that angle is opposite interior angles right there. So this 42 degrees is going to be the same as that, right? 42 degrees. And then looking at this, 42 degrees and 48 degrees, that adds up to 90 degrees. So for this triangle right here, the right angle is right there. All right. So this is a right triangle. Knowing that it's a right triangle, I can then apply the Pythagorean theorem to find x, because x is the side opposite of the right triangle. X is the hypotenuse. So the hypotenuse equals leg squared plus leg squared, right? So 10 squared plus 12 squared, right? Leg squared plus leg squared is the hypotenuse squared. In other words, x squared equals 100 plus 144. X squared equals 244. And so x equals the square root of 244. Now, what is that? 244, I think. Let's see. Yeah, so that's 61 times 4. So that's 4 times 61. And so x is equal to 2 square root of 61 miles. I don't know. I should probably get a decimal equivalent to that. I can just do square root of 244 if I want. So doing 2 square root of 61. Okay, so I have to hit the approximate button, and I get about 15.6 miles. And so that's the distance, right? So that's going to be this value right here, 15.6 miles. Approximately. Okay, so that's part one of the problem. Now, it also wanted us to find the bearing from the marina. So to find that, I need to look at this red arrow. Okay, that red arrow is the actual direction you need to go from the marina to catch up to the boat. Okay, so the bearing there has to start from the north, and it's going to require this angle here, theta. So I can see that bearing that I want is north theta degrees east, right? That's the bearing to the boat. So I need to figure out that theta right there from the north line. Okay, so I already know part of it, right? Part of it is 42 degrees. And I think I can use trig to find this angle. Let's call it alpha. And so the angle that I'm after would be 42 degrees plus alpha, right? That's my bearing angle that I need. So if I can find alpha, I can get the bearing to the boat. Okay, so that's the goal. We're after alpha. Now, the given information looks like was a side opposite and a side adjacent. This is a right triangle, so I can use right triangle trig. So opposite over adjacent again, I'm going to use tangent. So I can write tangent of that alpha is equal to opposite over adjacent, so 10 over 12, all right? And I'm after the angle, so I have to use tangent inverse of 10 over 12, which reduces, right? So that would be tangent inverse of 5/6. And so doing that on a calculator, do that. So tangent inverse of 5/6. And that comes out to 39.8 degrees. Now that's not the answer. 39.8 degrees is only part of the bearing, right? So it's 42. Remember, we're after theta. So 42 plus that alpha. So 42 degrees plus the 39.8 degrees. And so the theta that I'm after is approximately equal to 81.8 degrees. Okay, so once I know that angle, I can come back and I can finish off the bearing here. So the bearing to get to the boat, that red bearing would be, that red arrow would have bearing north, 81.8 degrees east. Right, so that's the answer for part B. That's the bearing that you'd have to take to catch up to the boat. Okay, so these are kind of tricky. They take a lot of practice. The key is drawing a good picture.